When you work with Excel, you often need to get data into your spreadsheets. There are many ways to do this, but most people don't know that Excel comes with a powerful tool that's made just for getting and cleaning data. For example, if you've had to take data from PDFs and into Excel, you've probably wasted hours on manually copying and pasting. And even if you haven't, you'll want to stick around to learn about this amazing but underused tool that comes free with modern Excel, because it will save you tons of frustration. We'll start by downloading a sample PDF. I'm on the investor relations site for Tesla. I'm going to scroll down to look for some PDFs. There are quarterly shareholder decks down here. I'm going to download the most recent one. So it opens up another tab, and I'll just go and click on the download button. Now I'm going to look for a table of data. Here we go. Here's the financial summary, and I'm going to do the first thing that most people do when they want to copy data into Excel. Select this, then press Ctrl C to copy, head into Excel, and press Ctrl V to paste. You can see that's put everything into one column, which is not very easy to use. I can try to fix this by dragging the data around, but there must be a better way to copy and paste data from a PDF into Excel. And it turns out that there's a clever hack to do just this. In level one, we're going to use a little known secret to shortcut the copy paste process. Here's the same PDF. I'll select and copy the values. Now I'll open Microsoft Word. So I'm going to press Ctrl V to paste this in. All we need to do is click on this bit to select the table, press Ctrl C to copy, head back into Excel, and press Ctrl V to paste. And just like that, we have all the data inside Excel. But as soon as you start working with larger tables that go over multiple pages, or you need to clean up the data using specific rules like removing certain rows, then using Word doesn't always work. And that's why we now turn to an even better way to get data from a PDF into Excel. It turns out that modern versions of Excel come with a powerful tool called Power Query. It helps us to get and clean data, and we'll use it in level 2 to convert our PDF table into Excel. Head to the Data tab, and then click on Get Data, and then From File, From PDF. So we click on this button, and we select our PDF, and click on Import. So it will bring up this navigator, and it's now parsing the PDF file so it can show what's inside it. Here we go. We're presented with these tables and pages. So the tables are what Power Query thinks are data that we want to extract, and the pages represent actual pages with text, not just data tables. So we've got to find the right table for us. Back here in the PDF reader, it says we're on page 4, and this table is the one we want. So let's find page 4, and this happens to be table 004. So we'll click on this, and it presents us with a preview. This looks correct, so it has all the columns and all of the rows. And we could straight away load this into Excel, but I notice that there are these null values, so let's just first get rid of these. And to do that, we need to head down into Transform Data. So click here. It's now processing, and it's finished, so it will show us the query. First thing I'm going to do is head into Query Settings and change the name. So with the name box done, we can look at the next box, which is Applied Steps. So there's 4 steps that have already been taken. We can click on the steps to see the details. So step 1 is Source. I can expand this box here, and you see this is the file we chose. And then step 2, Navigation, that shows table 004 is what we selected. Now, Promoted Headers is step 3. Take a look at the names. It says column 1, column 2, column 3, and then column 4. But we actually want these headers because that first row contains the actual table headers we want in Excel. So this next step promotes that first row up into the column headings. And step 4, Changed Type, actually acts on the data type that's used in each of these columns. So in step 4, you can see it's a number. And if I go back to step 3, you'll notice it says ABC, which stands for text. And as soon as we do step 4, it changes to a 1.2, which stands for a decimal number. So I'll close this box for now. We wanted to get rid of these empty rows. And it's quite easy to do that. Click on this dropdown, and then select Remove Empty. And there we are. We're left with only those rows that have values. And the final step is to close and load. So back in the Home tab, we can either click this button, which will close and load directly into a new sheet in Excel. But I want to load into an existing sheet, so I'm going to click the drop down. Close and load to is what we need. So it's asking us to select how we want to view this data. I want it as a table. Where do you want to put the data? I want it in the existing worksheet. And I can specify the location here. And then click on OK. And that brings the data from the PDF into a table in Excel on this level 2 worksheet. And what I'll do now is just change the format of the table so it looks consistent with my color scheme. And there we have it. If you want to follow along, you can get my Excel file for free in the video description. But don't go away just yet, because we're not done here. Do you see this column labeled YOY, which stands for year on year? And these rows showing gross margin and operating margin, which are percentages? What if we need to get rid of them because we only want the raw numbers like revenues, gross profit, and operating expenses? Is there a way to do this in Power Query? In level 3, we're going to do a bit of advanced stuff in Power Query that involves unpivoting and repivoting our table. I'll show you how to turn this old Excel table into this new Excel table that doesn't show the percentages. This is the previous query from level 2. We're going to create a new one. So head up to Data, and then Get Data, then choose From File and From PDF. Let's select the file and click Import. And now it's come up with the tables. If you remember, it was page 4 that we got table 004 from. So I'm going to click that. Just double check it's the same data, and it is. Then we'll click on Transform Data. Now it's processing, and now it's done. Let's change the name to something more descriptive. And let's look at the applied steps. Same as before, source, then navigation, promoted headers, and change type. This time, because we're going to do an unpivot and repivot so that we can get rid of the percentages, I'm going to actually remove this step. Because right now, what it's done is it's changed this column and all the other quarterly columns into numbers, but I don't want that. I click on this red cross, gets rid of that step, and it turns these data types back into text. And that's important because I want to be able to search for that percentage symbol. We're soon going to unpivot this data and then get rid of the percentages and then repivot it so it looks like this again. But when we do that, the order of these rows is going to be lost. And to prevent that from happening, what can we do? Well, we can go and add a column that's an index column here. I'll choose from 1, and then we can return to this original order after we've done our operations. But I also want to move this to the beginning, so I'll click on Transform, and the drop-down for Move, I'll select to Beginning. So there we go, the index column is on the left. Now if you remember, we're going to remove this column at the very end, which is YOY year on year. So to do that, I can right click on it and then click on Remove. And then we can head back to the beginning and select these two columns. So to do that, I'm going to hold Shift and click on the second column. And now we're going to unpivot the other columns. So I'll right click here and select Unpivot Other Columns. And what you can see now is that it split these into attribute, which is each quarter, and then the value for that quarter. It's now one very long table that goes all the way down. Now we've got it in this format, we can filter for the percentages. So I'm going to click up here and apply a text filter. And I want to filter for stuff that does not contain. Then enter the percent sign and click OK. So now we're left with just the numbers and not the percentages. And you can check by scrolling down. Next, we'll change the data type for the value column. So currently it's text. I'm going to click here and then select decimal number. So when we load this back into Excel, our data is going to be a number format and not text format. Now we're going to transform this back to a crosstab table. So I'll need to click on this attribute column, and then up in transform, I will select pivot column. I will choose a values column, which is this one here, and then click on OK. And you can see it's returned us to the original format. There's one more thing I noticed we haven't done, which is get rid of the empty rows. So I'm going to go here, click on that, and remove empty. And we don't need this column here, which is the index one, because we're about to bring this back into Excel. We can right click and click on remove. Finally, we can close and load this back to our Excel sheet. So I'm going to click on this drop down and choose Close and Load To. Then I want to select to view this data as a table. I want it in an existing worksheet, and B8 is the correct cell, this one here. Now I can click on OK. So it will take a little time to get the data. And when it's done, you see this table. I'll change the table style. And I'd like to change the number format. So I've got this custom format here that I'm going to copy. Then select the table and press Ctrl+1 to bring up format cells. I'll click on custom and replace general with Ctrl+V to paste the custom format, and then click on OK. And then these EPS earnings per share numbers, I'll need to increase the decimal so we can show that two decimal places. And now we have a new table that shows only the things we want to keep. So that's how Power Query can help you convert and clean data from a PDF. But it can also do so much more. It can even scrape data directly from the web so you don't have to spend hours copying and pasting, and then you can hit refresh to automatically update it. Watch this video next to find out how. And if you want to learn Power Query in depth, then check out my recommended resource in the description below.